Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is a friendly, gentle, and family-oriented sport. It is a ground fighting sport that emphasizes self-defense and uses leverage to gain an advantage over your opponent. Practitioners of this martial art usually are powerfully handsome, gain sweet biceps, and develop washboard abs. But this is the story of Mike, the fat jiu-jitsu guy.
So what do you think about that new Mike kid training?
You know, I've had worse students. No.
Keep your arms down.
Oh.
Good.
Turn on to your side. One time I had a guy who was legally blind. He was a paranoid schizophrenic, an alcoholic, chronically overate. He couldn't even touch his knees as far as flexibility goes. Actually, he was better than Mike too. Rotate your knee towards the ceiling. Wrong. Better. Keep your elbow down. Don't be afraid. Better. I did find him lost one time in the locker room. He couldn't find his way out.
His back away from me. Good. Bring your knee and your elbow together. Wrong. Other side.
I think we all understand the unique challenges Mike faces.
Escape your foot. Good.
Maybe I haven't had anyone worse than Mike.
So what do you think about that new Mike kid training?
Which one is that? Is he the boulder, the build guy?
The rounder guy, yeah.
Round, yeah. He's not that good. Pretty bad, actually, just in overall everything. I mean, kind of just throw him around. He's good, he's a good dummy.
After enrolling in an introductory jiu-jitsu class, Mike was constantly harassed by a large ginger. He would always be thrown to the ground, stomped on, and embarrassed in front of all the pretty girls that watch as man and men train in this awesome sport. It made Mike cry at night, and he vowed that he would train, get better, and beat the ginger known as Goliath.
Mike is good at, you know, being choked out. Then again, he does go back to the laying there. He's unconscious, so we have to bring him back, resuscitate him, and then once he's back, he just comes back to you choking him. So it's a vicious cycle for him.
Mike's heart was in it, but he was terrible. He was seemingly unteachable. His instructors were getting frustrated and thought that years of eating Twinkies had corroded Mike's brain. But Mike would not quit. He would beat the giant.
So I've known Mike for about a year now, and his jiu-jitsu has progressed a lot. I remember when he came in, he didn't know anything, and he was just this fat guy that was trying to run around in circles with us. And now he can run a little bit better in jiu-jitsu. He's gotten better. Yes. He's gotten better from where he came from in the beginning when he didn't know left from right.
What do you think about his chances of beating Goliath in his next fight?
Big ginger kid?
Yeah, big Irish-looking fuzzball.
Oh, I'm interested in being a gastroenterologist.
He might do it. He might pull it off. Upsets have happened before.
I mean, he is the, 2-1 underdog?
2-1? I was seeing 7-8-1.
Oh, man. Sure. I get my numbers confused.
Yeah, I wouldn't give him that much credit. That would suggest that two Mikes could beat one Goliath easily, and I would say it would take far more than that.
After 4 grueling days of training and lots of whey protein, Mike was ready to face the red-haired beast. He hoped that all of his blood, sweat, and tears would pay off.